I know that we have already covered the topic chemical kinetics, but one of the other friends had asked me one question related to this numerical. The numerical is the reaction to nitrous oxide plus two hydrogen molecules react with each other to form the nitrogen gas and water molecule. Okay, and this reaction occurs in the gaseous phase at high temperature. The reaction is started with equal concentration of the reactants. The following table gives Timer half means half life period values for different initial pressure, so that the reaction is third order. And it's very simple thing to understand how to solve this numerical. Now look over the table. The pressure is given in the unit of millimeter, and T1 half means half life period for the third order reaction is given in second. Okay, then friends, look over that. The, for the first cell, the pressure is 354 and the time is 81 second. Same thing for the second cell, 288 and 140 second. For third cell, it is a 243, 176 second and 202 millimeter pressure and 224 second. Then one thing is very important. First you read the numerical and understand what is the given term and how we can solve the numerical by a proper way to by using the minimum time. Okay, because the numerical is too much large and we think the method is too much difficult. Actually it is not happening like that. The numerical is very simple. Then you should understand that there is the two way to solve this numerical. The first way is, that is, you know that the Timer half for the third order reaction is we calculated by using this formula, thrice 283 into a square. Okay, now friends, we know this formula actually. We have already discussed the derivation regarding to this one. 3 bar twice K3 A square. K3 is the rate constant. A is an initial concentration regarding to the third order reaction. Okay. And then the another method in which some student can directly consider the rate equation and rate law formula is like that. 1 upon twice A square T in bracket X 2A minus A bracket complete. And in another at the denominator, A minus A is bracket square. Now you should be understand which one equation is used for this numerical. Which one equation is very important and useful to solve the numerical? This one or this? Now look toward the given data. Here data is your initial concentration is same for all the reactant. Okay. Therefore the A is initial concentration and it is the same. The pressure is changes with respect to time and time is given, that is a half life period. Therefore, which equation we use for this numerical? Of course, the T1 half equation we have to use for this numerical. That is, the T1 half is equal to thrice by 2 into K3 raised to A square. Because the concentration is given with respect to the half life period. And therefore, student, you can't consider this equation for to resolve or solve this numerical. Okay, then we get our equation. By using that equation we will solve the numerical. Which is that equation? The equation is given half. Okay, now the half life period is given. Therefore I just add in this equation in this form, K3 is equal to 3 upon twice T1 half into A. As a substitute value, what is the given or provided in the numerical? That is 3 bar 2 into, what is the given half for the first set? That is 81 second. Very good. And then we substitute the initial concentration, that is the 354 bracket square. And it's very simple multiplication and simple division. After resolving it, you will get 1.48 into 10 raised to minus 7. Then, square per second. Okay, this is the equation and this is the answer for the first cell. Same thing we repeat for the second cell. That is 3 bar 2 T1 half into understand it. You need to say as it is. Again we go toward the say 4. I just substitute the value. 2 into 2 and half a square. After substituting the value, I hope it is visible for you. 176 into, it is a 2 and half into 2. And the initial pressure, of course, in this is a gaseous situation, and therefore the pressure is given here. And after calculating, you will get answer that is the 1.49 into 10 raised to minus 7. Unit is 10 as per the above. And when you resolve or solve this numerical for the fourth set, you will get the answer 1.64 into 10 raised to minus 7. Millimeter square minus square per second. Okay, it is the uniform. Now friends, look toward that. We just want to prove that the given reaction is the third order reaction. Okay, and when we solve all the four sets, and we will be get the value of rate constant third order reaction. That is like this. Now look toward this fraction. This fraction is same for all the four sets, and on that basis we have clearly said that the given set of the reaction is the third order reaction. Then I hope you understand.